actually in Mount Vernon, Texas today, and had some extra free time, so I'm making use of my time. So I've got the address to where I am. I'll be talking to the city, the owner, the franchise owner of the property. I found some setbacks that need to be addressed. The parking lot, when it rains, all of it comes down, and it flows through these two little areas that get into the really nice urban street. I see a mimosa tree. We do have those in Oregon. It's a beautiful tree with flowers. But I'll kind of show you what I find. We take a water sample, and then we look at the trash. We take photos. We send in a video of this, and we contact the cities. And what we do is we ask them to clean it up. We ask them to address the setback that's impeding the environment. And we give them solutions. And if they're willing to pay us to do it, we'll do it. This one isn't extremely bad. They do pick it up on occasions, but I'll show you just kind of what I found today. So what we have today, I may have to get a stick, is a really cool, we have fire ants here, so you have to be really careful. So you have to be really careful because they will make you get everywhere. They'll make you dance, but I'll kind of show you. This one may be a dead one. They may spray to try to kill them. I don't know. We're kind of getting off the subject here, but it doesn't look like there's much going on. So they do use poison on this. So that's one thing I'm checking is where'd the fire ants go and who's killing them? What are you using to kill them? So in the creek here, we've got some definite, what do you call this little sludge on top? Can barely see it with the sun out so bright. There's a film on the water, and I may have to get in there a little closer, but we see, you know, of course, this. I can't step in this fire ant pile. They will maybe possibly get me. And then inside there, we have a lot of plastic bags. Looks like some Walmart possible to-go bags from grocery stores. They're not banned here. And this kind of standing water. So what we have when we have standing water is it creates mosquitoes, and there's a lot of mosquitoes here, and we don't like that. It keeps us out of the forest, and when I get bit when I clean it up. There's another plastic bag there. I'm gonna stand back and let you see how beautiful it is. It is pretty. It's got a lot of things going on, so it's just a little runoff creek that they have tripod to use, and the trees, it's not very big, lots of land here, zero trees. But fortunately, we do have a huge thicket, way better of a thicket in this area than we typically do in Corvallis around streams. Willow and other things, looks like alder berries, is that what that is? I'm not real positive, but I'll show you. Not real sure. Try not to guess, let the botanist do that. Can't really see it, but the mimosa tree is really pretty. I'll show you what a mimosa flower looks like. They do have them in Corvallis. You may be able to see one. That's it. But it's a common tree here. And I'll kind of show you what a point source runoff, what I call that is. And so all the water flows down the big parking lot here, and you can see where I am now. Steady people buying food. And so if you look over here, we found a few plastic things, plastic bottles. Those are coming out of cars. It's not that they did it. And then here is our little chute. And what I'll do now is I'm actually going to go to the website. I can probably get the building permit pretty easily. I'll find out length times width of this parking lot. And it'll tell me at 1 inch, at 2 inch, at 3 inch, how much rainwater comes off from here. And it'll give me ideas of what to plant right here. And right there, and at the other end, because more trees need to be there. We'll have to find out who owns this property. Probably that place, but if they do, that's even better. It's easy to get approval. And what I'll do is write a bid to them about what it'll cost to clean this up, go through here and get rid of any invasive plants that are in there, and then how much it'll cost that we'll charge to plant trees here and there. They're more than welcome to do it themselves, but we're going to give them a solution to keeping this stream a little bit cleaner. And to make sure that we don't have such standing water at the mouth area of this, and we can make the standing water by cleaning out what's in this little area in there, we can let it go further in there, away from where people are parking and things like that. But I'm just kind of sharing what we do and how we make use of our nonprofit to work with others to get them to think of the environment more than just their business. And you can see what's floating on top of it. Typically, usually what this is, we will get a water sample of that. Typically it's oil from cars dripping in the parking lots, and it rains and it flows in here. You know, you never know what that stuff is. Sometimes I have coffee and it has something like that floating on top. There's a little Jimmy the Cricket. I don't know if you can see him. He's floating. But so we'll test this water and see if there's a coli bacteria in it. I doubt it. It looks pretty clear. The clarity is very clear. There's nothing moving. No minnows, no fish or anything. But anyway, just kind of letting you see what's going on in Texas and how we kind of work with others to, I guess we could say we call them out. But technically, we're just sharing values, and we, it's a nice willow tree. We just share values in how we can better our land and create more habitat for birds and wildlife. There is a hawk over here. I couldn't see him. It would be nice to have a sweet hawk on video, see what a Texas hawk looks like. Probably the same. I just hear him, I don't see him. But anyway, welcome to what I do. Thanks for supporting me. Thanks for caring. Thanks for sharing the same belief with us. And, you know, just one stream at a time cleans the ocean every day. And all this trash ends up in the ocean if we, if we don't do something about it. So, thank you guys. See you again.